the deliverables are actually step by step. And you do know, in the manifesto that was recently just released, there is actually more on the table now under maternity care for women, whereby now you're saying for the first year, all mothers and all children will be covered. And I think that's wonderful, because really the first 12 months of a child's life are so key. The vaccines, and for the longest time, and I know because I'm a young mother, you know, for the longest time you're visiting the clinics, and there are two lines. There's the GOK line, then there's the other line where people can afford private vaccines.
Yes.
So I think that's very commendable.
That's very, very commendable.
Now, just one thing on this maternal care, healthcare. The only critics you will find of the free maternity program are men.
Absolutely.
And there are men who are disconnected from the realities of the world, because it is women who can tell this story best.
Yes.
You know, and this is really a debate that should be left to our women.
Correct.
Because our men simply don't get and understand, first of all, even the intervention of free maternity and being able to provide grants to clinics and hospitals for that was one intervention that people would debate on. And you'd find governments, county governments, saying, we are not going to provide this service because we want all the money. The issue is not really about the money. The money will come if you provide the service. Number two is that moving it from being a transaction of just the pregnancy and the childbirth, itself, to now looking at the prenatal and the postnatal intervention, I think takes the interaction with the mother to the next level, the mother and child. And really, that section of the manifesto, I can tell you, because I was involved, was written by a mother who understands what it is that the women of this country require.